Hello everyone, welcome to online classes. Myself Sushma Kamath, lecturer in computer science, Dr. A.V. Badega, PU College of Commerce, Kumta. Dear students, we have started the second unit, that is input, output and memory devices. This is our third session on this topic. Students, we have already studied about input devices and output devices. Let us just revise them one by one. First one, input devices. In input devices, we have studied keyboard, mouse, OMR, webcam, joystick, OCR, scanner, MICR, barcode reader, mic, light pen, etc. These are all input devices. What they do? They just give data and instructions to the computer. Then the second session we have discussed about output devices. What are the output devices? Monitors, printers and speakers are most commonly used output devices. What they do? They just give the result or information from computer to the user. They output the result to the user. That is what output device. In today's lecture, today's class, we discuss about memory devices. What is memory devices and why they are used? I'll take an example, a mathematical example. Okay, 2 plus 3, how much? 5. We instantly give the result, right? Let us take one more example. 2500 into 3677. What you will do? You will take a pen and paper, you start writing that the sum and whatever calculations, and then you calculate and give me the result. So here, whatever processing is done at your head should be written, should be stored somewhere. If there are simple ones like 2 plus 3, what it will be done? It will be stored, calculated in your brain only, and that is your primary memory. Whereas second case, when we give the larger sums and larger calculations, what we do? We take a paper or something else like calculator to do the calculations. And that is what you, the calculations, whatever calculation also done here, but it you need a additional support, and that is secondary device. So let us discuss more about my memory devices. Memory devices are those devices which stores data or programs or instructions which are required for the CPU and the result generated after processing. It does two work. One, it stores data and instruction, that is programs required by CPU, and after that, after processing, the result whatever is get will be stored in these devices. For example, 2 plus 3, 2 is first, this is our instruction. 2 and 3 are data, plus is your instruction. What this will be done? It will be taken by our mind, it is stored somewhere, then calculated, that is processed, and result 5 will be given. And again this 5 is first initially stored in our mind, then it will be outputted. So that's how the concept works. Same way in our memory devices also. The whole thing is whatever instructions, data is given, first stored in your memory, and then that will be given to the CPU for processing. And whatever result is generated after processing will be again stored in your memory, and it will be outputted through output devices. How does memory works? And the capacity, all these things of memory will be counted. The storage capacity of computer is measured in terms of bytes. Memory device in a storage anna bytes alli measure madlagtade. What is byte? 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. How many bits? 8 bits. What is bits? Bits stands for binary digits. What is binary digits? Binary digits are nothing but combinations of zeros and ones. Each bit is 8 combination of 0 and 1. Each byte is 8 combination of 0 and 1. 1 bit means either 0 or 1. Why it is like that? See, everything, whatever in a computer is in the form of 0 and 1. Why it is so? Simple. Computer is an electronic device, as you all know. So whatever instruction, whatever things will be given, for example, fan. Take an electronic device, fan. How it works? It works 0 and 1, on-off technique. And this on-off is used here as 0 and 1. 1 for on, 0 for off. Like that means the flow of electricity and stop of electricity. Like that works. Similarly, for storing data in your memory device, we use the same concept as 0 and 1. Either 0. So, initial, the smallest measurement is in terms of bits, and then comes bytes. Bytes means 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. Let us have a look at these memory measurements and all. The table given below gives storage capacities. Let us have a look at that once again. So, 1 byte. 1 byte is equal to 8 bits, 8 combination of zeros and ones. Followed by kilobyte, 1 KB is equal to 1024 byte. Then megabyte, 1 MB is equal to 1024 KB. Then gigabyte, GB, 1024 MB. Terabyte, 1024 GB. You have heard the terms MB, GB and TB, right? These days, these terms are very common. Then petabyte, that is 1024 TB. Then comes hexa, zeta, zeto, bronto and gigabyte. Like that, our measurement, memory measurements goes on. So everything starts from 1 byte. Let us go further in detail about memory of our computers. Computer has two major types of memory. One is primary memory, another one is secondary memory. Primary memory is semiconductor memory, whereas secondary is also called as auxiliary memory. In olden days, it was called as magnetic memory also. Now, in primary memory, that is again divided into three types: ROM, RAM and cache. ROM memory again divided into three: PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Whereas RAM divided into EDORAM, SRAM and DDRAM, like that. The secondary memory is divided into three types: magnetic, optical and portable. Magnetic is divided again into hard disk, floppy disk and magnetic tapes. Optical memory is again divided into compact, DVD and Blu-ray disk. The portables are those which we use commonly, pen drives, memory cards, they all come under here. So let us discuss everything in detail in our today's session. So first one, primary memory. What is primary memory? Primary memory is main memory of your computer, which is placed inside our CPU, It's also called as main memory of your computer. It has three types. First one, ROM, read only memory. Second one, RAM, random access memory. Third one, cache. Pronounce it as cache memory. Cache memory, okay? So, first one, read only memory. Second type, RAM, random access memory. Third one, cache memory. The primary memory is main memory of the computer. Primary memory nama computer ina main memory anta idu ati mukhyavada memory. Computer CPU olagadene idu place agirtade normally. What it will do, in kelsa martade, it stores programs and data which are currently needed by CPU. CPU ge at present CPU yav kelsa martirtadala ಆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವಂತ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಡೇಟಾ ಈ ಮೂರು ಮೆಮೊರಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ದ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಟ್, ಸಿಪಿಯು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಮೊದಲು ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಜೊತೆ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಅಥವಾ ಮೇನ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಜೊತೆ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಅದು ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಅದರ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಅದರ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಆಸ್ ಸಿಪಿಯು ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಎಟ್ ಹೈ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್. ಸಿಪಿಯು ತುಂಬ ಸ್ಪೀಡಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಈ ಮೂರು ಮೆಮೊರಿಗಳು ಹೈ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಇರುತ್ತದೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಇವು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇಂಟರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತವೆ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಮೆಮೊರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹೈ ಹೌ ಡಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ವರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ರೋಮ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಡಿಟೇಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ರೋಮ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ರೋಮ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. Whereas for RAM, Random Access Memory, EDORAM, SRAM and DDRAM. The first one, Read Only Memory. PROM, EPROM and EEPROM. What is that? Let us understand first one. PROM, Full Form, Programmable Read Only Memory. EPROM, Erasable, Programmable, Read-Only Memory. EEPROM, Electrically Erasable, Programmable, Read-Only Memory. So what is ROM? ROM is a memory chip, card, whatever, wherein the program is already recorded by the manufacturer. Manufacturer ಯಾವಾಗ ಚಿಪ್ ಅನ್ನು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ ಆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲೇ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬರೆದಿರ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಮೆಮೊರೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಈ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಮಗೆ ಓದ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ವಾಪಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ರಿರೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ರಿರೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೀರೈಟ್ ದೆಮ್ Once the data has returned into ROM chip, cannot be erased, but you can read it. When you switch off the computer, whatever in the ROM will not be vanished. You computer na off madidru, power off madidru, alli yaudu erase agodilla. They will be there for permanently. Which memory li? ROM memory li matra idu. So that's why ROM. Read only memory which is inside your CPU. ROM is a non-volatile memory. ROM permanent memory. ಇದು volatile ಅಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ power off ಮಾಡಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ದಿರೋದು ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. It's a permanent type of memory. That's why read only memory. ROM stores the critical programs which are needed for booting of your computer and some critical conditions of your computer on your critical machine illi r type programs irthade yavaga nam computer on agbekidre koduvanta instructions irbodu andre nam operating system load agukinta modle bekagiruvanta instructions galu athwa kelavu critical condition galalli bekagiruvanta instructions galanna rom alli store madlagutade yar store martare adanna manufacturer who develops who designs the read only memory a chip rom chip anna yar develop martare that person can write the program so that's why read only memory these are only readable not rewritten or not cannot be erased so next type let us discuss the read only memory in detail the first one is PROM Programmable read-only memory. Here, data and instructions can be written once, but it was not written by the manufacturer of the chip. Instead of, it is written by the programmer. See, sometimes what happens, a programmer wants his own program to be written on the read-only memory, ROM chip. For that, what he will do? Manufacturer will just manufacture that chip and programmer later he writes using special device that is programmable read only memory here programmer burn that chip and write whatever instructions he want so this is PROM the next type is EEPROM erasable programmable read only memory so second one is EEPROM erasable programmable read only memory Here, the information can be erased and reprogrammed using special PROM programmer. Here what happens, the programmer can erase it, whatever he written, and rewrite that on the same chip. And for that, he uses ultraviolet radiation. He uses ultraviolet radiation for erasing as well as rewriting on your ROM chip. The difference between PROM is pre-ROM once can be programmed by programmer, whereas EEPROM can be once programmed, again erase, again program, like that he can do it. That's why erasable, programmable. And for all these works can be done by the programmer with the special devices. They are used to burn and write the codes on that particular ROM chip. Next one, the third type, EEPROM. Electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. Here the user, or sorry, programmer, what he will do, he will erase that one. It is same type of erasable programmable, only difference is instead of ultraviolet radiation, here electricity is used, electric signals or pulses are used to read as well as writing on that ROM part, ROM chip. Here also the programmer will write the instruction he needed for his ROM chip through electrically, it's done by electrical methods, electrical pulses or charges. That's why this type of ROM is called as EEPROM, erasable, electrically erasable programmable ROM. Erasable programmable ಅಲ್ಲಿ ultraviolet radiation ಅನ್ನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ electrical charger or electrical pulses are used to write on ROM chip, burning of ROM chip. That's why this particular ROM is called as electrically erasable programmable read-only memory, EEPROM. Once again, ROM has three types, programmable, where programmer can write on the special device, that's why programmable. Second one, EEPROM, erasable programmable read-only memory. Here ultraviolet radiation is used for erasing and rewriting the program. The first one, once it is written, it is finished, it can't be erasable, whereas second one, it can be rewritten using the special ultraviolet radiation devices. Third one, electrically erasable programmable. Here the programs are erased and rewritten using electric pulses or charges. That's why this third part. So these are the three types of ROM, read only memory. Next one, random access memory. Next one is random access memory. Here random access, it has three types, EDORAM, SRAM and DDR RAM. Let us discuss them one by one. RAM is also a main memory of your computer. You have already heard the term RAM in your day-to-day life. This really a main storage of your computer. It's actually a main storage. Idu actual main storage of your computer, which stores the programs temporarily. In term nenpitkoli, temporary. It stores the program data and instructions temporarily. Next one, the CPU needs to store the instructions to be processed as well as data needed to process those instructions and results to be stored somewhere. And for these activities can be carried out by your RAM, random access memory, which can is a temporary memory. When you switch off your computer, whatever there on your RAM will be vanished. That's why this is also called as volatile memory. Once again, RAM main memory agirtade actually. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಯಾವ ಟೈಪಲ್ಲಿ? ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಗೇನು ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಡೇಟಾ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್, ಇದು ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಯಾವಾಗ ನೀವು ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಪವರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಶಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ, ಆವಾಗ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾನಿಷಸ್, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಲೀಟೆಡ್. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ರೋಮ್ ಹಾಗಲ್ಲ, ರೋಮ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾನ್ ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್. ರೋಮಲ್ಲಿ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೂ ಆ ಡೇಟಾ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಆದರೆ ರ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಏನು ಡೇಟಾ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರರಿ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರರಿ. ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಟೈಪ್. ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಮೆಮೊರಿನ ರೀಡ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಫಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಡಿಯೋ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟೆಲ್ ಪೆಂಟಿಯಮ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್. ಇಂಟೆಲ್ನ ಪೆಂಟಿಯಮ್ ಸಿರೀಸಲ್ಲಿ, ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಸಿರೀಸಲ್ಲಿ ದೀಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಇಡಿಯೋ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಾಸ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮೈಸ್ಡ್ ಅಥವಾ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 66 MZ ಮೆಗಾಹರ್ಟ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆಂಟಿಯಮ್ ಫೋರ್, ಪೆಂಟಿಯಮ್ ಸಿರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಷೀನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡೆಡ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್, ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಈಸ್ ದರ್ ಡೈನಾಮಿಕ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಸೆಮಿಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಬೈ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಈಚ್ ಬಿಟ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂಥ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಬೈ ಸ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಚಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ದ ಬಿಟ್. ಒಂದೊಂದು ಬಿಟ್ಟನ್ನು ಈ ಮೆಮೊರಿಲಿ ಆ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರಿಫ್ರೆಶ್ಡ್ ಪೀರಿಯಾಡಿಕಲಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪೀರಿಯಾಡಿಕಲ್ ರಿಫ್ರೆಶ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದ್ಯಾರ್ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ಯು ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್. ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್, ಡಬಲ್ ಡೇಟಾ ರೇಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಅದರ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ಡಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ರೇಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ. ದ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಶನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಸಮ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲ್ ಯೂಸೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್, ಡಬಲ್ ಡೇಟಾ ರೇಟ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಆರ್ಕಿಟೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್, ಇಟ್ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಡೇಟಾ ರೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಪ್ಗ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಟು ಡಬಲ್ ರೇಟ್. ದ ಕ್ಲಾಕ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಟು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಟು ಸಿಪಿಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಟು ದ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಟು ಸಿಪಿಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಟು ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಹೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಸ್ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ, ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದೆನ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ರೋಮ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಡ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರೋಮ್, ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್. ರೋಮ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್. ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಅಲೋಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ಅಲೋಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಅಲೋಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್. ಯೂಸರ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೀಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ರೈಟ್, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ರೋಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್. ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಡೆವಲಪರ್, ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮರ್ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನುಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಚರರ್, ದೇ ರೈಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಡೇಟಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ರೋಮ್. ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಯೂಸರ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೋಮ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ರೋಮ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾನ್ ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್. ರೋಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ವಿಚ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ರೋಮ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ವಾನಿಶ್. ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ವಾಲೆಟೈಲ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಇಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾನಿಶಸ್. ದ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರೋಮ್, ಪಿ ರೋಮ್, ಇ ಪಿ ರೋಮ್, ಇಇ ಪಿ ರೋಮ್. ಪಿ ರೋಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮೇಬಲ್ ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ಇ ಪಿ ರೋಮ್ Erasable Programmable Read Only Memory, EEP ROM stands for Electrically Erasable Programmable Read Only Memory. Whereas RAM has two types actually, static and dynamic. Again, whatever they are redesigned such a way that EDO RAM and SRAM and DDR RAM, like that. So that's how the entire system RAM and ROM works. The next one, cache memory. Pronounce it as cache memory. Placed between, this is a special type of memory placed between CPU and your main memory, that is RAM or ROM. CPU matte main memory madhya vandu special memory device irtude, and that memory device we call that cache memory. Idu tumba fast agi work madutte. This is very fast compared to RAM. How does that work? RAM speed CPU speed kinta kadme irtade. RAM alli data read agodu athwa write agoo speed CPU compare madidre normally kadme irtade. ಅವಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಸಪೋರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ದಟ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಲಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಸಿಪಿಯು ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತದೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಟೈಮ್ ಸೇವ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸಿಬಲ್ ಟು ಯೂಸರ್. ಯೂಸರ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸಿಬಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಮ್ ಬಟ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನಾಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸೆಸ್ cache memory. It stores instructions and data needed that which are to be executed immediately. Andre next instruction in CPU execute martadalla athwa instant execute martadalla aa instructions anna cache memory li store martare. So that is cache memory. It's placed between CPU and RAM. It used to reduce the average access time of data which is normally stored in RAM memory. RAM memory ಗಿಂತ ಇದು ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಡೇಟಾನ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಹೊಂದಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೇಟಾ. RAM ಇಂದ ಸಿಪಿಯು ಹೋಗುವಂತ ಏನ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಚ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿಯರ್ ದೆನ್ RAM, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇನ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. RAM ಗಿಂತ ತುಂಬ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅದರ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ದ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲೆಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್, L1 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ L2. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲುಕ್ ಎಟ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ CPU, ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ CPU. ಇನ್ ದಟ್ CPU ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಚಿಪ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಪ್ರೊಸೆಸರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಹಿಯರ್ this is L1 cache and here this is L2 cache. This is your RAM, random access memory. Whatever instructions to be processed by CPU, the immediate next instruction will be stored here or here depending upon the requirement. That's why this is an intermediate memory between your main memory and the CPU and the CPU. Clear? The second type of memory is secondary memory, which is also called as auxiliary memory. Olden days, it was actually developed using magnetizable properties, magnetic materials and all. That's why they are called as magnetic memory also. But nowadays, they are developed in various form. That's why another type of memory is optical. Secondary memory, there are mainly two types, magnetic and optical. And one more is that portable storage devices in the third section. Now let us discuss all these one by one. Why this is used? This is actually used for bulk storage of your data, program and instructions or informations in your computer as well as supporting devices. So secondary memory, the most common one, you have heard about hard disk, floppy disk, CDs, DVDs, they are all come under this type of memory, that is secondary memory. Here, when the CPU is there and there is a memory, in between the RAM will be there. The whatever content in the secondary memory will be loaded to RAM and then that will be given to CPU. Clear? So the time taken from secondary to CPU or CPU to back to secondary, that time is called as access time. That time is called as access time. Clear? So let us discuss more about secondary memory. Types of secondary memory. The mainly of two types or third type is nowadays we are using. The first one, magnetic. They are again divided into hard disk, floppy disk and magnetic tapes. Whereas second one, that is optical, they are divided into compact, DVD and Blu-ray. Last one is portable. Let us discuss these things one by one. So first one, magnetic. First type is magnetic. Magnetic is nothing but, it was created, why the name came? It was created using a magnetizable material, that is metal oxides. That's why those memories are called as magnetic memories. All hard disks, floppy disks and magnetic tapes comes under this particular type. Here the thin plastic disk or plastic material are used to develop this secondary memory. Here the various type of materials can be used, size may be different but the mechanism is same. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಥಿನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಅಥವಾ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟೈಸೇಬಲ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೋಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಪಲ್ಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟೈಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟೈಸ್ ಹೀಗೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಡಾಟ್ಸ್ ಹಾಕಿ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್. ಆ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡೀ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರಿಂದ ದೀಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್, ಫ್ಲಾಪಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಟೇಪ್, ಇವುಗಳನ್ನು ಒಂದಾಗಿ ಒಂದಾಗಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಕಾಮನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಜನರಲಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಸಿಪಿಯು. ಸಿಪಿಯು ಒಳಗಡೆನೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಈ ಮೆಮೊರಿ. ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಒಂದು ಸರ್ಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಮಧ್ಯ ಥ್ರೂ ವಿಚ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಸ್, ಕೋಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಆ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಮೇಲೆ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಕೋಟ್, ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟೈಸೇಬಲ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಕೋಟ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ರೀಡ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಹೆಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೂವ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ರೊಟೇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ದಟ್ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್. ದಿಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲಿ ದ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್, ಸಚ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ and which stores the data on it. The each disk is divided into concentric circles called as track and they are again divided into small sections called as sectors. In each sector the whatever memory will be stored. Same concept mele mundin kelav disk galallu work aagtade. Here electromagnetic recording heads are used for reading as well as writing purpose. Let us have a look at your hard disk. So this is your hard disk. Here you can see this is your circular disk, okay, and this is your reading as well as writing head. This disk rotates at the speed of 7200 rpm rotations per minute and all, depending upon the hard disk manufacturer the speed may be vary. And this disk head moves like this so that the whole disk can be read. This is how that hard disk concepts work. See, this is hard disk here. There are mainly two types of hard disk. One is fixed, which is fixed inside your computer. Another one is removable, which you can take anywhere. That's why it's removable. So these two are the types of hard disk. Next one, floppy disk. What is floppy disk? Floppy disk is a small plastic disk. I'll show you floppy disk here. So this is floppy disk. This is your floppy disk. Here inside this there is a thin film of plastic made up of mylar plastic. This here, if you move like this you can see that film, okay. That film is coated with magnetizable material. Magnetizable material. A film mele magnetizable material coat agirthade. Here there is a point where your these things one pin bartade ee riti matte reading and writing can be done through this area here. Clear? That's how work. Ilon small opening ide that is used for protecting your floppy from getting corrupted. Protecting your floppy from getting corrupted. See, this is the pin. This is one for write protection. Close agate matte open agate to write, protect your floppy. Floppy disks are very small. You can carry it anywhere without any issues. That's why they are portable ones. They are portable ones. But the drawback of floppy is the size of your floppy is available in 3.5 inches, 5.2 inches and 8 inch diameter. 8 inch diameter. That's why you can see, have a look at your floppy. See, what I showed here is 3.5 inch floppy. And what is the capacity of, maximum capacity of floppy is 1.44 MB. How much? 1.44 MB. That much small size it's. And one more drawback of floppy is, actually floppy get corrupted very easily. Floppy bega corrupt aagutade. Hagagi swalpa moisture, dhoolu, yavade exposure aadru floppy corrupt aagutade and it get very easily affected to with the virus. So due to that, floppy become nowadays outdated. Nobody uses floppy these days because of the smaller size, easy corruption, they get corrupted, files get corrupted very easily, and the moisture and your other things will affect surrounding environment, affect your floppy. That's why the floppy disk will be not used these days. So next one, magnetic tapes. Have you seen the audio cassettes which we have used in tape recorder and all olden days? The same cassettes were redeveloped for computers. They are nothing but your audio cassettes. I'll show you one video cassette here, which is that the same concept it works. See, this is the video cassette. Here it is a tape. On this tape, the end tape is magnetized, and on this tape, whatever content is written. Here there are two circular areas where your rotations will be controlled, and this here there is a head which will read the content on your disk. This is your, actually it is a video tape which is used for video and other purpose. So this is magnetic tape. Idan idu VCR tape il torsta irodu audio tape nimma tape recorder alli use madantadu computer ge use madu ide concept alle develop agirodu idu computer ge use madu anta magnetic tape. It's one of the serial access disk hagagi idu tumba time consume agutte yakant heltane naavu yavdo one song ge hogbeku andre naavu tape recorder alli move forward athwa backward maartivi correct ah because the head reads serially. Same concept alli illi kuda computer alli work agodrinda it takes much time to access a particular file. Neevu alli forward athwa backward maadi aa point ig hogi nimma file ana access maadbekagittu. This is one of the serial access disk. Clear? So next type of memory is optical memory. Next type is optical memory. They are of three types: compact, DVDs and Blu-ray. Let us discuss them one by one. Before that, let us understand what is optical memory. Optical memory is that memory. Optical means light and glass. Optics, the term optics stands for light and glass. Here the memory, entire memory used to write using, read or write using light radiations. That's why this type of memory is called as optical memory. It's compact, removable, random access. So it become very popular these days. So it's a random access, removable, easy to carry from one place to another, and data is read laser beams. Data is read through laser beams here. That's why this type of memory is optical memory. Optical disk consists of a rotating disk which is coated with highly reflective material. ಈ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಹೈಲಿ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಕೋಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಮಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಲೈಟ್ ರೇಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ದಟ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಲೇಸರ್ ಬೀಮ್ ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಟು ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೀರೋ ಸೆಟ್ ಒನ್ಸ್. ಜೀರೋ ಮತ್ತೆ ಒನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಲೈಟ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್. And that makes that concept is used for optical writing. Here the dark spots are called as pits and light spots are called as land. Light spots are called as land. Dark spot anna now pit anta karitave, light spot anna land anta karitave. In spots ishtu microscopic, they are microscopic spots. They are not big enough or they cannot be visible to common naked eyes. Next one. The first one is compact disc, commonly called as CD. This is your compact disc. This is your compact disc. You can see here highly reflective material, light material is used coated on this, and here the light contents will be written. The size of the compact disc is 600 MB. Starts from 600 to 800 MB. ಸೈಜ್ ಎಷ್ಟಿದೆ 600 to 800 ಎಂ ಬಿವರೆಗೂ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಇನ್ಫ್ರಾರೆಡ್ ಲೇಸರ್ ಬೀಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್. ಇನ್ಫ್ರಾರೆಡ್ ಲೇಸರ್ ಬೀಮ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್. ಸಿ ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್. ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್, ಇದು ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್. ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ, ರೀರೈಟೇಬಲ್. ಸಿ ಡಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಮಾತ್ರ ಓದ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಬರೆದ ನಂತರ ಓದ್ಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗುವಂಥ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ. ಆದರೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ ರೀರೈಟೇಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಬರೆದು ಅರಿಸಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರೆಯುವಂಥ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ. ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೇಬಲ್ ಆರ್ ರೀಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀರೈಟೇಬಲ್. ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಡಬ್ಲ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರೀರೈಟೇಬಲ್. Next one. So this is your CD here. You can see here the CD, the chip outer part of the disk, and data information area. Idu data matte information area. Illi hole. See. Here it is a hole opening. Idu horagade do data matte information na illi barthirtara. Clear? Next. You can see here. CDR, CDRW, CD ಮೇಲೆ ನಾರ್ಮಲಿ ಬರೆದಿರ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾವುದು ಸಿ ಡಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೇಬಲ್ ಸಿ ಡಿನ ಅಥವಾ ರೀರೈಟೇಬಲ್ ಅಂತ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀಟಾಗಿ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಬರೆದಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡೇಬಲ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು, ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪಲ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಆದರೆ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಬರೆದಿದ್ದು ಡಿಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದರೆ ರೀರೈಟೇಬಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮರೆದು ಡಿಲೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇರೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬರೆಯೋದು ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು. ದಾಟ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಈಸ್ ಡಿವಿಡಿ, ಡಿಜಿಟಲ್ ವರ್ಸಟೈಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಮನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಜಿಟಲ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೂವೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್. ಕಾಮನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಡಿಜಿಟಲ್ ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್, ಬಟ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಜಿಟಲ್ ವರ್ಸಟೈಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ಡಿವಿಡಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಸೈಡೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಸೈಡೆಡ್. ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಲೇಯರ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿವಿಡಿ ವೇರೀಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ 4.7 GB ಗಿಗಾಬೈಟ್ ಟು 17 GB, ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಿಡಿಸ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 700 MB ಟು 800 MB, 600 to 800 MB, depending upon the manufacturer it may slightly vary. So this is a DVD is available of two types, DVD-R, that is DVD recordable, And second one, DVD rewritable, means once you can erase and rewrite that one. That's why they are again available in two tabs, DVD recordable, DVD rewritable. And most of important thing is, for here writing of DVD, the red laser is used. For writing of the DVD, red laser is used. That's why it is DVD. You can have a look at here. So DVD are recordable. Capacity is also written on the DVD, 4.7 GB. And this is DVD RW, rewritable. This, to writing DVD, the red laser beam is used. For writing, red laser beam is used. The next one, Blu-ray disc. Blu-ray disc referred as BD. It's commonly used, its capacity is much higher, that is 25 GB to 50 GB, depending upon the layers and other concepts here. And it looks same as your CDs and DVDs. Only difference here is, for reading as well as writing purpose, blue violet color is used. Idrali CD li infrared use madidre, DVD ge red laser, illi blue violet laser beams are used for reading as well as writing purpose. That's why they are called as blue ray disc. Spelling nodi, idu tappilla spelling, it's called ನಿಮ್ಮ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಬ್ಲೂ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಬಿ ಎಲ್ ಯು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇದೆ, ಇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಪೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಬ್ಲೂ ರೇ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಲೂ ರೇ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ ಯು. ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. ದ ಪೋರ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ನಾವು ಈಸಿಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಆಗುವಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಡಿವೈಸ್ಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಪೋರ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ದ ಕಾಮನ್ ಫ್ಲ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ರೈವ್ಸ್, ಪೆನ್ ಡ್ರೈವ್ಸ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇದು ಇದ್ರ ಮೆಮೊರಿ, ಪೆನ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಚಿಪ್, ಇಂಥದ್ದೇ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕ್ಯಾಮೆರಾಸಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಚಿಪ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಟೇಬಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಡಿವೈಸಸ್. Here the technique used is, they are developed with solid state conductors, circuits mele ivugalu develop agirodrinda they come under slightly different. Nowadays solid state formally nimma hard disk kuda available ide. The writing speed and everything was increased due to that. The pen drives and hard disks are available in various size, shapes and quantity, whatever methods. So these days pen drives with C type connectivity connection also available. Nimge bekagad size alli, shape alli, matte convenience salvagi various form alli pen drives and disks are, memory chips are available. You can use them as you want. The highest capacity of hard disk is some 55 TB, normal magnetic hard disk adre. Solid state ige solid state around 100 TB. Okay, ashtu capacity solid state alli hard disks are available, which are portable as well as fixed formally available ide. Then pen drives are available 2 TB varegu pen drive easily available ide market alli, up to 2 TB. The cost is around 10,000 somewhat for one pen drive and so on. Like that the portable storages are available. You can see these are the pen drives, these are the portable hard disks, which they are developed, not normal magnetic hard disk allow you, they used developed with semiconductor and other flash memory type anta helteve adanna use maadi develop maadirodu. They are there in your market available. They are the third type of secondary memories. So this is, let us revise about once again all the memories and difference between primary and secondary memory. Primary memory is semiconductor memory. Secondary can be optical, magnetic or semiconductor wise. Primary volatile, or temporary, whereas secondary, permanent. Primary, most of the primary, that is volatile. They can be easily, once you switch off your computer, they will vanish. Secondary, aariti alla. Nimmalli secondary is proper store agidre, until you delete that or it get corrupted, it will be there. Primary, high speed and very expensive. Secondary, less expensive, but speed wise they are much slower. Primary tumba fast a kelsa maduttade adre expensive. Secondary solpa slow kelsa maduttave adre less expensive. Primary is called as main memory. Secondary is also called as auxiliary memory. Primary ge example RAM, ROM. Secondary ge example hard disk, pen drive, DVD, CD, etc. Clear? Once again, primary made up of secondary semiconductors, whereas secondary is made up of magnetic or optical material. Primary volatile, secondary permanent, non-volatile. Primary expensive, secondary less expensive. Primary faster, secondary less faster or slower. Primary is also called as main memory, secondary is also called as auxiliary memory. Examples, RAM, ROM. Example for secondary is hard disk and pen drive. CD, DVD, well, secondary. Next, let us conclude this session. Here we have understood memory. There is type of memory as primary and secondary. In primary, we have understood ROM, read only memory. Read only memory li more type PROM, EPROM matte EEPROM. PROM stands for programmable read only memory. EPROM stands for erasable programmable read only memory. EEPROM stands for electrically erasable programmable read only memory. The next one, RAM, random access memory. They are of two types, three types: EDORAM, SRAM and DDR RAM. Then comes cache memory. Cache memory. In secondary, we have three types: magnetic, optical and portable. Magnetics are of three types: hard disk, floppy disk and magnetic tapes. These days, floppy disks and magnetic tapes are not used because of their issues like easily corrupted, size is very small, maintenance is difficult, all these issues, due to those issues they are not used, outdated ones, whereas hard disk commonly used. Optical, compact, DVD and Blu-ray, there are three types. These are also nowadays becoming outdated, but still you can see them, they can be used, they are available in the market. Last one, portable. Due to portable, many of these were not used. Portable alli pen drives, nimma portable hard disks, memory cards, memory chips, they are all under portable memories. So this is all about memory. Next one, let us conclude this entire unit. The first session we have understood input unit, that is keyboard, scanner, mouse, OCR, mic, joystick, MICR, webcam, OMR and barcode readers. They are all input devices. Input devices are those which gives data and instructions to the computer, that is CPU. CPU ge instruction matte data koduvanta all devices are come under this section, input devices. Then the second one, output devices. Output device yavudu? Yavudu CPU dinda namge data matte instructions anna, information anna, andre processed data anna kodutade. They are output device. CPU inda horagade baruvanta ella horagade world jothe communicate aguvanta all devices come under that particular section. In output units, the most common one are monitors and printers. Monitors are of three types: CTR, cathode ray tube, LCD, liquid crystal display, TFT, thin film transistors, and last one, LED, light emitting diode. And again, printers, the types of printers we have impact and non-impact. Impact again divided into line and character. That again divided, line is again divided into drum and chain, whereas character, daisy wheel and dot matrix. Nowadays these impact printers are only dot matrix is still used, others are outdated become. Whereas non-impact alloy, three, thermal, laser and inkjet, which are still commonly used in many areas of our day-to-day life. Then one more output device, speaker. Speaker of three type, which is audio, it converts audio signals. It namge audible agiruvanta electric signals, electric data na, digital data na audible form ge convert madutha. They are speakers. 2.1, 5.1 matte 7.1 ide. Mattondu plotters. So all these are output devices. Then today's class we have discussed memory unit. There is again primary, secondary. Primarily RAM, ROM, cache, and secondarily magnetic, optical and portable. That is again divided. So to conclude this session, any doubts are there, please write it on your comment section. Thank you.